It's time for the weekly No Pain, No Gain market update with a team at Payne Capital Management here in New York City.
Good morning. This is Bob Payne, Chief Investment Officer and Managing Director of Payne Capital Management. The global markets this week continued to be a market at the mercy of the noise from the news headlines. As Yogi Berra so famously said, it's like deja vu all over again. Just when we were feeling comfortable about the situation in Italy, now popularly known as Quitaly, an event where Italy proposed to leave the euro. The Trump administration placed tariffs on steel and aluminum, prompting retaliatory threats from Canada, Mexico, and the European Union. And of course, we still have China threatening their own tariffs. Many believe it's all a negotiating tactic, but the market seems to be having a hard time making up its mind. My guess, when it comes to geopolitical risk, as again has Yogi again famously said, it's not over till it's over. On a more positive front, the U.S. economy continues to show strength, adding 223,000 new jobs in May. Now, that's up from 164,000 in the month of April, while the unemployment rate stands at 3.8%. That's the lowest level since 2008. Average hourly earnings, as predicted, grew at 2.7% year over year. For the month and for the year, growth stocks in the U.S. continue to outpace all other asset classes, especially value stocks, with small company growth stocks up over 8% year-to-date, almost double their mid and large company counterparts. In general, as we enter a new month, U.S. stocks are now outperforming non-U.S. stocks, and commodities, for the first time in years, is outperforming the Dow and the S&P 500. And what may be a short-term flight to quality, interest rates declined and all bonds rallied on the week. So when you put it all together, most portfolios are treading water, either up or down 1% for the year. But there's still a long way to go to year end. And most years, the market returns in the double digits. Of course, that's both positive and negative. Although we are in the 10th year of a big booming bull market, keep in mind, double digit returns are not the outlier, they're the norm. So as I say, and maybe Yogi should have, you have to be in it to win it.